All right, so on this incredibly cold Saturday morning, we're back at the exhaust shop, but not for my car this time, for the homie Alex. Known him for about a good 7-8 years, and this is his 2017 Chevy Silverado LTZ. The day he got it, he parked it all up in my driveway like, yep. Anyway, in this video, you guys are gonna hear my voiceover like right now, and obviously audio from the actual clips, because, you know, it's just fun to hear what we're talking about sometimes. It's a little funny. But basically, in this video, he wants to get his straight piped, or he wants to get a little bit of tone added into his exhaust, because he saw what I did with my charger. He saw what was popping, what I did with my charger, stuff like that, so he wants to do that too. So we're gonna go ahead and hook him up, at least try to in this video. He seems pretty satisfied with the actual results. I'm gonna give you guys a before and an after, of course, because I wasn't there for the before. He didn't, you know, I mean, I didn't really think about doing that type, but he sent me a video and stuff like that. Anyway, hope you guys enjoy this video, because we're back at this exact same exhaust shop. I think I'm helping these guys out, because I'm bringing a little bit of business. My bad voiceover again. I'm just here to clear things up and explain pretty much what's going on. So when we got there, you know, Alex wanted me to talk for him because he doesn't know too much about cars. So I pretty much told him that we wanted a straight pipe, because what he did with my car wasn't too long ago. So hopefully he would remember kind of what was going on. I know not all cars are the same, of course. You know, it's a little bit different, because my car, the Charger, it has two pipes, and his truck only has one thick pipe that's coming out the rear. So basically what he was telling us is that for that truck, they're quiet pretty much no matter what you do. You really have to like kind of torque the exhaust a little bit, put all kinds of different things on there to actually get what you want just out of that generation of truck. So basically what he said is that he can cut both mufflers off, the big muffler right there and then the small muffler, and then he can pretty much straight pipe it and just put one little carbon muffler on there. So the first thing they did was cut the giant muffler off located next to the gas tank on the bottom of that truck, and from that point we started up to see how it sounded, and Alex was not really impressed with it. So I told him to cut off the last muffler, the tiny one that curves down over the rear axle. From that point, they straight piped it. Alex decided to add two chrome tips to the rear just to give it a better look. And at that point, it sounded a lot better. It wasn't like how it was, of course, you know, factory. It sounded a lot better for what the guy was talking about, because the guy said he's always done trucks like that, like trucks from that generation with the same engine and everything. And it's just that GM truck from that generation. It's just the way that they have the exhaust and the engine set up. Even with the V8, it's just not going to be as loud as you expect it to be. It's just that truck. I mean, nothing wrong with the truck. It's just that's the way that they built it, because the older Chevys and stuff like that, they're pretty loud. You know, you can make them pretty much as loud as you want and stuff like that, but it's just that specific truck. It's just, you know, it's surprisingly enough, because I'm thinking it's a V, when we got there, I'm thinking it's a V8. Oh, all you gotta do is straight pipe that thing, take these two mufflers off, and it's just gonna be ridiculously loud, like a Corvette or something like that. But that was not the case with this truck, which is fine, because they took off the front muffler and the rear muffler. They put an aftermarket carbon, I think that's what you call it, muffler, and then they straight pipe the rest of it. Alex says he's pretty cool with the two. He's, you know, it's loud, because he doesn't drive too fast, and I'm telling him, like, you need to, like, kind of step on it to actually hear, like, what you got. But, of course, he drives slow as hell, and he can't really, you know, he thinks it's quieter than it actually is, but it's actually louder than he actually expects. You just kind of got to get on it a little bit more. Your RPM's got to be over 3,000 or 4,000. Anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. He is impressed with the results. I am impressed with the results even a little bit more than he is, because, you know, the way the guy was talking, like, oh, you know, it's just this truck. It's just not going to be as loud as you expect it is. It's just a generation of GM trucks. It's just the way they engineered it. It's just not going to be what you expect. But I am impressed with it. I think it sounds pretty good for a truck like that. It could be a lot better. Obviously, it could be a lot louder. But then again, you don't want to piss your neighbors off. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. It's DOS, and this is